And now, America's number one show on pop culture and politics. This is the Michael Medved Show.
And another great day in this greatest nation on God's green earth. But there is a great deal of outrage in the internet and elsewhere where Jeff Sessions, the Attorney General of the United States, was speaking before the National Sheriff's Association. And this has produced a huge explosion of controversy. Listen closely and see if you spot something outrageous that America's chief law enforcement officer had to say to the sheriffs.
I want to thank every sheriff in America. Since our founding, the independently elected sheriff has been the people's protector, who keeps law enforcement close to and accountable to people through the elective process. The office of sheriff is a critical part of the Anglo-American heritage of law enforcement. We must never erode this historic office. I know this. You know this. We want to be partners. We don't want to be bosses. We want to strengthen you and help you be more effective in your work.
Okay. Did you notice a problem there? Is that something that we should have bleeped out? Something that is a, quote, dog whistle that has a racist undertone? Brian Schatz, the senator from Hawaii, yesterday he tweeted, do you know anyone who says Anglo-American heritage in a sentence? What could possibly be the purpose of saying that other than to pit Americans against each other? For the chief law enforcement officer to use a dog whistle like that is appalling. Best no vote I ever cast. He means he voted no on confirming Jeff Sessions to be attorney general. This is pathetic. He says, can you imagine anyone ever using that term? You know, there was another senator who served alongside Jeff Sessions, actually, back in the earlier years of the 21st century. And that other senator, wow, he used that same hate-filled, repulsive statement. Listen, see if you recognize the voice.
I hope we remember this as we go forward. I sincerely hope that we can protect what's been called the Great Writ, a writ that's been in place in the Anglo-American legal system for over 700 years.
Okay. Is that a huge problem, or is it just a problem when Republicans say it? Rockstar Greg Tomlin just saw that I was tweeted at regarding some of what we were talking about last hour by an actor named Andy Kindler, who says, hi, Medved Show, stop whining about Jeff Sessions being called what he is, a racist. The GOP is the party of racism, hate-mongering, and white nationalism. You know Trump is a birther, right? Well, he's a recovering birther. You never quite recover from that embarrassment, as far as I'm concerned. He says, you are a fraud, meaning not Trump, me. And thank God you're on AM 870, The Answer, and not an actual radio station. I'm very proud to be on AM 870, The Answer. And one of the great radio stations in the country. And Andy, the GOP is the party of racism and hate mongering and white nationalism. My guess is that you're not old enough to remember what real open racism looks like. Part of what happens here is there's the old story of crying wolf. If you're outraged about everything, then you got nothing left when there really is something outrageous. Now, is it possible that Jeff Sessions would say or do something outrageous? Yes, but he didn't when he said that being a sheriff and being a locally elected sheriff was part of our Anglo-American heritage. Why is that racist? Is it inherently racist to take pride in some of the ideas that we share with the mother country? The country that helped to give birth to the United States of America, because the colonies that came together to form this country, which has always been based on a series of ideas, those ideas go back to England. They do. And it's one of those wonderful things. I love the fact that English is my language. I do. It gives you access to the greatest of all literary traditions, and I believe that it is. And to say that is not racist, because some of the people who've used the English language exceptionally well include people of every color and every ethnicity and every national origin. I mean, good grief. This is bizarre. Bizarre. And then this came in another disagreeing tweet. What on earth are you talking about today? You will go above and beyond to pretend you don't understand privilege and privilege speak. How is it, speaking to sheriffs? By the way, do you think sheriffs are really privileged people in our society? Really? Sheriffs and deputy sheriffs work very hard, are exposed to all kinds of danger. It is not, I'll tell you what's privilege. What's privilege is working in the movie industry and having a regular job. You think you get paid more as a sheriff? You think you get more public acclaim and respect and adoration? You should get more applause because you're actually doing the kind of work that allows the rest of us to live and one hopes to prosper and to be happy.